Getting a computer science degree is one of the smartest decisions you can make. While people often talk about degrees not being as useful anymore, this is certainly not the case here. Getting a computer science degree will open up lots of high-paying tech jobs in fields like software engineering, data science, UX design, web development, IT, AI, machine learning, and more. Companies love CS degrees, and you're way more likely to get hired for one of these jobs with this degree. But a computer science degree certainly isn't for everyone, and in the media, it's been misrepresented for years now. That's why computer science is one of the highest dropout rates of any college major. And if you go in with the wrong expectations, you're going to waste years of your life. So let's clear everything up in this video. The first reason why you shouldn't study computer science is programming. There's a high chance that you're considering computer science because of programming. And that's correct, but it's also something many people misunderstand about CS. Computer science is not about programming, but programming is a part of computer science. You're not going to spend all of your time programming as a CS major. In reality, a CS degree is structured like this. You have the fundamentals, theoretical computer science like algorithms, computation, data structures and so on. You have the computer architecture, operating systems, networks, and how computers communicate and how everything works. All of these things that programmers don't usually think much about, to be honest. Next, we of course have software engineering, and it's where programming, development, and testing comes in. But there are also many fields or subfields in computer science that are interconnected with other fields, like computer engineering, for example, to understand certain aspects of how computer architecture works as well. So computer science is not just a study of programming, but rather it's the study of computers and computational systems. Next, we have the math. And I'm gonna scare some people away with this by mentioning the math, but it's actually not that bad. Theoretical computer science is basically a branch of mathematics. Math is a foundational part of computer systems because they're built on math, but it's not necessarily the math that you think about. When you go for a CS degree, you'll take several math courses. We're talking about calculus, linear algebra, discrete math, and statistics and probability. But your mathematical studies will often focus more on computer science concepts and things that actually are relevant and important to computer science. What I think is really cool about CS is that many of the concepts you learn are going to be useful later somehow, especially in discrete math, dealing with countable or distinct structures. What you actually end up doing in your job depends on the role you end up with. As a web developer, you're not really going to be using all of the advanced math that you learn, but it's still valuable to learn. People that come from programming bootcamps and short online courses often struggle a lot with this. They simply don't have the time or will to teach you all of these fundamentals, especially the math. And often for good reason, because you don't need every single thing for all roles. If you just want to get a job fast, a bootcamp can be fine. But if you have that solid foundation, it's easier to transition between different roles and also get into more senior and more technical roles. Now, let's talk about competition, which is a real problem, especially for CS majors. And this might be contradicting everything that you've heard, but there are a lot of available jobs for people with computer science degrees, and many jobs have high salaries. It's an amazing job market, and people are really happy with their jobs, because employers need people with these computer science skills. But the thing is that not all jobs are the same. For some, there is a lot of competition. For example, if you want to become a software engineer, a data scientist, or another top role, there will be a lot of competition for these jobs. Especially as a beginner, entry level, there are just too many applicants compared to the amount of available jobs. Some would even go as far as to call it a skill gap, because skilled people are in very high demand, there are not enough experts, but there are also not enough jobs for beginners, because companies want the experts, so don't expect to just graduate and just land one of these roles right away. It's likely gonna take other stuff, like building a solid portfolio, doing some internships, or whatever you need to get your foot in the door, especially if you're looking for the top roles like software engineer, data scientist, and so on. Reason number four is about computer science itself as a field, because it's not an easy thing to master. There are a lot of complex things you have to learn in computer science, and there is a reason why it's ranked as a very hard major. And even for the practical aspects of programming, to become a good programmer, you need a lot of time and practice programming. Therefore, the workload during your studies will depend a little bit on the program and university, but it's going to be a lot. Some universities are more relaxed, whereas others completely flood you with assignments and short due dates. The combination of difficult topics with a high volume of assignments can be very difficult for people. And that's honestly one of the reasons why computer science, again, has one of the highest failure and dropout rates. Now, the exact numbers aren't really clear, but it seems like roughly 1/3 of CS majors don't progress to the second year. Isn't that absolutely crazy? Now, in reality, it's likely also because people realize that it's not all about programming, as we mentioned earlier. The hype around programming and software development and getting those kind of jobs have led to a lot of people signing up for a long CS degree without really understanding what it's all about. And these are the main people that drop out, for good reason. They basically realize that it wasn't for them and that CS isn't something that they should do. So perhaps they took a bootcamp instead and maybe they're really happy with it. And that is why it's so important to know what you're getting into, that CS is not all about programming. Now, the most important thing to see success, and this is more important than any of the other things, is that you enjoy what you do. I know that it sounds really cheesy, but it is true. But I don't want to say it like most people that are like, pick a career you just love. Of course, you have to consider other aspects as well, like job security, financial opportunities, and so on. Do you have to be an absolute fanatic and just love everything about it? No, but you shouldn't hate what you're getting into. If you have the passion for computer science and a clear vision, you'll do really well in the field. You don't need to be a genius. Honestly, ask yourself about it, because it's important. It's also a very general degree in many ways. You don't have to love every course you take. I don't think anyone loves all of their courses, regardless of what major or what the thing they're studying. We have to do hard things and take courses we don't like to reach our goals. That's completely fine. And I think it's also really important not to mix that up. Like, difficulty and being interested in something are two different things. It can still be difficult even if you're interested. So I don't want to discourage anyone from getting a computer science degree, but rather to, you know, show you the reality, which in my opinion isn't bad, but it's certainly not for everyone. Do your own research. I think that's the most important thing. A computer science degree can be the best or the worst decision you make. It all depends on who you are, and I'm not here to tell you that. That's up to you. Good luck. I'm sure you'll do great. Watch this video next. The YouTube algorithm picked it specifically for you, and I think it was assigned by somebody who took at least one CS class. So enjoy this next video.